Sergei Alexandrovich had created everything he owned with his own hands. It was the result of a lifetime of hard work. He felt that no one had given him anything. There were no arranged jobs. And he hadn't inherited a substantial fortune. Nevertheless, he had acquired quite a few possessions. However, family was undoubtedly the most important. With his wife and daughter taking precedence. Then came his respected work and significant responsibilities. Along with his own career, there were also symbols of city life. Including a large apartment in the old district of Moscow. Filled with laughter. He possessed all the other trappings of metropolitan life. A luxurious country villa. A splendid car. And various other smaller items. Furthermore, he participated in various forums, summits, company exhibitions, and other events. He found contentment and happiness in this kind of life. A pursuit he had embraced since he was young when he realized he was an independent individual. He was born in a small but picturesque village near Moscow. In the Tyvolsky district. Situated along one of Russia's great rivers. Sergei's parents were the village's elite, his mother was a doctor. And his father a veterinarian. Widely regarded as the most popular and respected figures in the village. However, from a young age, he couldn't stand medicine. With its endless late-night calls, whether for cattle or village residents. Growing increasingly impatient. Sometimes even neighbors would knock on their door with a small dog that had swallowed something. He detested those never-ending nightmares when his father would quickly set up an operating table in the kitchen, take out his medical toolkit, and fill the air with the smell of medicine, along with blood and dirt, and the cries of the patient. Sergei felt repulsed by those smells and sounds, longing to escape home and play with his friends. He was certain that he would not pursue a medical-related profession in the future. For himself, Sergei decided that when he grew up, he would move to Moscow, study to become a banker, and never return home. True to his determination, he pursued his goal relentlessly. After graduating from high school, he gained admission to Moscow State University's economics department. Earning his degree with honors and then finding employment. He rarely returned home. Instead marrying one of his college classmates in Moscow. And they had a daughter together. Life progressed steadily as Sergei rapidly climbed the career ladder. Then, circumstances changed. And the nation's societal system underwent transformations. Sergei Alexandrovich began working in a bank. Initially as a department manager. And later. He was promoted to the bank's chief financial officer. Before long, he had amassed a considerable fortune. He eventually left the bank and established his own business. Opening his own bank. He remembered everything vividly. How it all began. And how that autumn changed everything. Turning his life upside down. Everything in his life was about to change. His life had been stable and orderly until one day he was invited on a hunting trip. Sergei had never been fond of hunting since childhood. But he believed it was crucial for his business. A way to establish necessary and beneficial connections vital for business operations. He explained to his wife that going hunting was to get closer to the people he needed. Especially potential future partners. Despite his dislike for hunting and everything related to nature. Even ignoring his wife and daughter's requests for a cat or a dog over the years. Sergei Alexandrovich firmly stated that his home would never have long-haired and tailed animals. But now, his potential partners had arranged for the night in an old cabin right in the middle of the forest. Hunter Peter Petrovich explained everything. Who would stand where? When the shooting would begin. and he requested that nobody smoke or make unnecessary noise, waiting for the animals to be driven towards the hunters. The whole event left Sergei Alexandrovich feeling bored and disgusted. He thought about the suffering of the poor animals he had witnessed as a child. He detested it all, hating the fact that just because you were human and held a weapon, you could harm innocent life. He couldn't restrain himself. So Sergei Alexandrovich decided not to participate in the hunt. He firmly refused to shoot innocent animals, informing his hunting companions that he would be wandering through the forest, breathing in fresh air, clearing his thoughts, and rejoining them in the cabin in the evening. He told them, "You go ahead with the hunt, I will take a walk in the forest." Despite their objections, Sergei knew they needed him in the bank just as much. So they reluctantly agreed. Early in the morning, everyone went their separate ways. The hunters went one direction, while the banker went another. He didn't even carry a firearm, just strolling through the forest, savoring the autumn air, walking on the yellowing leaves, over the moist silver moss, and breathing in the clear and intoxicating air. He felt wonderful, alone in the forest, thinking to himself, "What a beautiful stroll in the forest." He was grateful he had refused the slaughter of the day. The banker reached a small clearing, sat on a sunlit tree stump, and had some food with him, as he needed to replenish his energy before returning. However, suddenly, he had a feeling deep within that he wasn't alone, that something was closely observing him. But it wasn't human, it was something else. In the forest, there were only wild animals. And he turned his head to notice two bright amber eyes. In the pine tree grove, a lynx. Sergei Alexandrovich began to look around warily. At first, he was afraid and thought about going back to the hunter's cabin, following the path he had taken. But it seemed he wasn't destined to return so easily. Fear had taken root deep within him. He believed that life wouldn't end so easily. So he took out his hunting knife. However, the lynx never attacked him. It had an entirely different purpose. It emerged from its hiding place, clearly visible, and placed a small life on the ground, its cub, before swiftly leaving the forest. The banker sat there for a while, completely still and deeply puzzled. The lynx cub was injured. When he decided to take the cub home, he was astonished. Despite defying the laws of nature, the lynx mother had placed her trust in this man. Sergei Alexandrovich was filled with excitement as he held the cub tightly in his arms and began to make his way back home. Sergei Alexandrovich walked for 2 months, and he noticed that the lynx was tirelessly following him, keeping pace with his steps. When he finally returned to Peter Petrovich's place, he recalled his father, and he began to think about what his father had done. Now, he understood the feelings that arise when a person helps helpless creatures. He now understood his father. Together with the hunter, they returned the cub to nature, handing it back to the mother who had been circling the edge of the forest. The wise old hunter told him that at that moment, he had realized that life wasn't just about banks and money. It was about serving the forest and its inhabitants. No matter how long he ran from it, fate would always find him. This time in the nearby nature reserve. The hunter agreed. And Sergei Alexandrovich noticed that there were many poachers who needed someone to oversee them. Now he understood that he needed to make a complete change in his life and wipe away everything that had come before. He could no longer stay in the city. He needed to venture deep into the wilderness, surrounded by wildlife. He returned to Moscow, sold his business, brought his family into nature, accepted Peter Petrovich's position, and built a large house. Now, He was completely content and happy in his life. This story is very touching. And I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked this story, please like and subscribe to the channel for more interesting tales ahead. Wishing you all the best, animals showing emotion can be unexpected. The weeping mother bear took the man to her dying cub. But what the bear did later really shocked Kyle's love of nature. As a child, he enjoyed hiking and watching animals at the zoo near his home. And he even studied to become a veterinarian. And now he can help animals whenever he wants. Being able to treat pets and even some larger animals is an amazing experience. He was even able to go to the zoo and work with some of the larger animals he used to see as a child. It's a perfect cycle. But working as a veterinarian can also be very difficult. He will love the animals around him, most of which he has seen since childhood. But he couldn't help all the animals all the time. Sometimes he tried his best but couldn't save them. He knows he should probably learn to maintain an emotional distance from the animals in his care. But he just can't. Every time he has terrible results, he will be very sad. But then he would still go to the next patient. And again he cared about them the way he always cared for all the animals in his care. After working as a veterinarian for several years, he realized he needed a place where he could go to rest and recover. He loves hanging out with his friends in the city. But that's not the same as really taking a break and replenishing. When he's stuck to do this, he needs to go back to the way he relaxed as a child, back to nature. He was able to take a few hikes close to the city. But none were long enough for him to really relax. He's done a good job. So he decides to reward himself with a cabin in the woods. It's not connected to a lot of land, but it borders a national park. That means he has plenty of room for long hikes. Since it is a national park, no one will build anything on the land. He will always go out with his little shelter. He can sit on his porch and watch the birds and hawks in the sky. And even watch some deer and other animals pass by the door. This is exactly what he needs. You can't hear any horns or other city noises here. All he hears are animals and the sounds of nature. When he decided to head to the woods, he had a particularly long week. He had just put his handbag in the cabin, took off his overalls, put on his hiking boots. And then he grabbed an apple and was ready for a walk. As he chewed, he breathed in the fresh air and listened to the distant sound of the river. His heart felt like it had been beating too fast for days. But now everything was slowing down and he could start thinking clearly again. When he had been on the road for a while, he saw a bear blocking his way. It was some distance away from him. But he knew he needed to keep it at a distance. But the bears had different ideas. She came over to him. Kyle stepped back slowly, looking at her out of the corner of his eye, and at the same time going back in the direction he came from. He knew better than to try to run away. But the bear kept coming towards him. At this time, another move caught Kyle's attention. Next to the bear, a cub emerges from the woods, making the situation even more dangerous. A mother bear can be more aggressive than a single bear. And he needs to be careful. The bear still moved forward. And Kyle understood that retreating was no use. He had to try a different approach. With his arms up high, he tried to look taller. Kyle made as much noise as he could, stomping and yelling, hoping the brown bear wouldn't come near him again. But something really weird happened. She didn't do what he expected at all. He had experience caring for bears at zoos. So he saw other problems. The bear didn't retreat the way he expected. And she didn't give any indication that she would engage in the aggressive chase-like behavior he expected. It was one of the strangest animal encounters he's ever had. She sat down in the forest with her cub crawling around her. But it looked like the mother bear was crying. She looked completely defeated. It touched Kyle's heart. And he knew he was taking a big risk. But he was getting closer and closer to the bear. Is she hurt? It looked like she was desperate. But he didn't see her display any behavior. Despite his experience, Kyle was at a loss and could only use his intuition to figure out what the bear needed. As he came nearer, the bear stood up. But instead of coming towards him, she started walking towards the river. She looked back behind her, as if asking him to follow. Curious about her strange behavior, Kyle had to follow. And it does look like she's asking for help. Helping animals was his life's work. And if it could help her, he couldn't help it. Bear doesn't even seem to notice when her baby starts running around Kyle and trying to befriend her. Fully focused on her destination, she led him to the river, which was almost full of fishing nets in the middle. The bear walked towards it. Kyle doesn't understand why she's so interested in the net at first. But then it starts moving and the other cub is completely entangled in it. Whenever water flows through the net, the baby bear will be submerged. It looked like the bear had tried to pull the net away. But she was unable to free her cub due to the tangled mess of the net. She needs human help to save her baby. This is what she so desperately wants to communicate with Kyle. There is not much time left. The little bear has become unresponsive. And he needs to rescue the little bear. He didn't bring anything. And he didn't have a knife to cut the net. And he didn't have time to run home to get one. When he came back, it was too late to save the bear. He had to find another way. He ran down the bank, checked all the stones, and found a rock with sharp edges and jagged edges. Then he swam quickly to where the cub was in the water. He cut the rope of the fishing net. The process took a while and left his hands bleeding and sore. But he couldn't stop. There was finally enough room for the cub to free himself from the tangled net. Kyle pulled him out and swam him to the bank, followed by his anxious mother. Little Bear didn't move. But Kyle made up his mind. He began to press on the bear's chest. And finally, it began to breathe. Exhausted, Kyle sat aside. The little bear stood up on trembling legs and ran towards his mother and brother. Mom hugged him tightly. After a while, when she was sure he was perfectly fine, she let him play with his brother. And the little family went back into the forest. When Kyle finally regained his strength, he started walking home. He walks away from what just happened. He may never see the family again. But he is very happy and has a great story to tell all his friends. He went home and took a hot shower. The little bear may be small, but he's still heavy. Kyle felt his muscles burn. But now he can rest. The next morning, he sat on the porch drinking coffee. After wrapping up his adventurous excursion the previous day, he was content to sit back and relax. But he couldn't believe what happened next. He was taken aback when the bear and her cub came into view again. The bear's family had come to visit him. For a long time after that, every time he was in the cabin in the woods, the mother bear and the cubs he had rescued would visit him. Thanks for watching again. Join us for more inspiring stories.